Let the word go forth here and now that the struggle for freedom is still alive, and the story of that struggle is still being told. We begin with guttural cries and wrenching moans and visceral groans and weary lament and silent tears. And how this grand people of African descent could transfigure such misery into joy and a sense of sustaining themselves against overwhelming odds. What a story, what a drama. Vicious theft from Africa. Pernicious passage to the New World America. Atrocious enslavement on ugly plantations. Yet in wooden churches on God-forsaken creeks, in makeshift churches, they would forge a connection with a biblical story.
Every child of God,
running for Jesus,
just like an automobile.
The first great art created in America. The spirituals proclaiming the good news in bad news situations. Connecting the sense of self against a society that told them they were nobody and no one. Keep keeping on was the theme. And then the painful laughter of the grand art. The blues themselves. The tragic comic sensibility of keep keeping on against the odds. Being down so long, the down don't worry us no more, and keep keeping on anyhow. Nothing like it in the world. Private agony and public misery could still not hold us back. We never allow misery to have the last word, even if all you could do is sing a song or a little moan. Or even crack a smile. Then the most sophisticated, the most refined art ever created, not just in America, but in the 20th century. Jazz itself. European instruments. New World African sensibility. The fusion of finding your own voice, but always in community, bouncing off against other voices to elevate the high quality of the collective performance of the quartet, or the orchestra, or the quintet, or maybe just a solo. Too many geniuses to mention, but Armstrong and Ellington and Monk and Coltrane and Vaughan and Holiday will have to do just at the moment. And then rhythm and blues, mellow, the sharing of soothing sweetness. We thank Brother Derek Allen and his musical genius for providing contribution in the tradition of Marvin Gaye, Luther Vandross, Curtis Mayfield, Aretha Franklin, and so many innumerable others. But then comes hip-hop, the greatest creative breakthrough in the last 25 years of the younger generation, fusing linguistic virtuosity with rhythmic velocity, something unprecedented, as well as the other earlier developments in the history of not just black music, 20th century music, modern music, all connected to struggle for freedom. The music soothes our bruises,
It caresses our bruises. It attempts to give us a foretaste of the freedom we so deeply want, even if we can experience it only for a moment. For a moment. For a moment. The struggle goes on. The story must be told and retold. Every generation must be connected to that story to be linked to that struggle for freedom. Come with us as we unfold the story and lay bare the drama.